The armor study, however, found that fluoroquinolone showed significant increase in inactivity against all Staph aureus. The resistance among Pseudomonas aeruginosa isolates to cephalosporins, fluoroquinolones, and carbapenems also increased, and it was found as an important finding of this study. However, the study found that there was either no increase or a marginal reduction of the incidence of methicillin resistance among Staph aureus compared to the incidence seen in 2005. The study also looked at the susceptibility of resistant isolate to other antibiotic, and they found that contrary to susceptible Staph aureus, methicillin resistant Staph aureus and other coagulase negative Staph, they are resistant to multiple classes of antibiotic. And you can look at this graph, which clearly shows that many of the methicillin resistant isolates are resistant to three or more classes of antibiotics. We were the first to publish antibiotic resistance among Pseudomonas isolates against fluoroquinolone, and the work was published in the Journal of Ophthalmology in 1999. In this paper, we analyzed the susceptibility of Pseudomonas isolates from keratitis cases and looked at the susceptibility to first generation fluoroquinolone, which was recently launched at that point of time in India. In 1993, only 6.2% of the isolates were resistant to fluoroquinolone, which progressively increased year by year. And in the June 1998, it became 23. So there was a significant increase in the resistance level between 1993 to 1998.